How's it going, guys? Well, it's been a while since I posted a video. If you follow me on Instagram, last weekend was not good to me. So I figured I'd do a video because I've had a lot of questions. People asking me how do I do a drop shot with the Meegs. Especially this time of year when those fish are very finicky, that might give you that extra little bite or that fish that you probably wouldn't have caught if you just were using the Meegs or using a vibrato, whatever you're using. So this is a drop shot kind of line that you can use with anything. It doesn't have to be the Meegs, but that's how I use it, especially in springtime. I think it's almost like 50-50 in springtime whether they're going to hit the Meegs or they're going to hit the high hook. So let me show you how to do this knot. Very simple, guys, not very complicated at all. So let's get into it. Guys, let's get to it. So pretend like I got my Meegs tied on or a vibrato, whatever you're using, doesn't matter. And you're thinking, I want to put a drop shot hook on. Well, what do? I don't want to cut the Meegs and then have to retie everything. Simple as this. So about 18, 20 inches where I like to go. You can go a little bit higher if you wanted to, it's fine. Just don't get yourself in trouble where if you have a hook or you have a fish on the bottom hook and you reel up all the way to the top and your drop shot hook gets caught on your rod, you have enough arm length to get down there and grab the fish. Or if you're fishing with a buddy, you don't have to worry about that. But 18, 20, 24 inches, kind of like the good, kind of a good way to start. So what I'll do is I'll do my 18, 20 inches. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna be doing the polymer knot. So if you guys don't know the polymer knot, very simple knot, very strong. I use it for lake trout fishing, use it for salmon fishing. And that's what you'll do to tie your drop shot hook. So you grab a drop shot hook here. Like I said, any drop shot hook, doesn't matter, get a quality one, Gamagatsu, Mustad hooks, they make good quality ones. So I'm not sponsoring anybody, so you go buy whatever you feel comfortable buying. I just don't cheap out on hooks, so do yourself a favor, grab yourself some good hooks. So fold it in half, I don't know if you can see that, and then you're gonna grab that half and you're gonna put it through the hook just like that. So I don't know if you guys see that, so now it's right through. So give yourself some extra line just to make sure. And you're gonna do an overhand knot. So again, this is the polymer knot. So if you guys don't know, it's basically like an overhand knot, like you'll tie your shoelaces. So I'm gonna grab it, twist it, grab a hole like that, go through the hoop, just like that. So now if you see it, so don't pull tight yet. So I just did an overhand knot. And now I have in my hand here, I have that loop. So you're gonna take your hook, put it through that loop, just like that. And now you're gonna pull tight. You're gonna obviously wet your knot first. I'm not gonna do that because I don't think you wanna see my saliva. And you're just gonna pull tight, guys, and that's all you're doing. Once you pull tight, there you go. Your hook's ready to go. And then you can put on whatever you want. So I basically use all kinds of stuff. I'll try basically your tube that you put behind your Meegs, kind of like this. I'll put that on here, just feed it through like that, and boom, there's your drop shot bait. You can put the drifter, have a whole bunch here, you know, put your drifter on top of that, some little nymph plastics, doesn't matter, whatever you feel comfortable putting on. I just try different things all the time. What I find works best is matching your tube to your drop shot bait, whatever you're putting up there. All right, so the other option is you can buy basically drop shot hooks with swivels on it. So this is already comes with the swivels, anything like that. You just tie your lines to it, very simple, and it allows the bait to kind of swim freely. These work really well too. So both options work well. If you're not comfortable doing the polymer knot, you can just buy these and then, you know, hook it up yourself, no problem. So hopefully this helps you guys out. I hope you guys can see how to do the polymer knot, but if you didn't really see it too well in this video, guys, just Google it. There's a bunch of YouTube videos, a bunch of, you know, just Google polymer knot and it goes step by step how to do it. And it's as simple as it is, guys. So hopefully that helps you guys get some more bites. All the links will be in the description below of the drop shot hooks and where to get them. And hopefully we'll see you on the ice.